Hello friends, welcome to Electronic Circuit Hub. So today we will understand introduction to power conversion part 2. So in part 1 we have already seen the techniques of power conversion, how a energy can be converted from one form to another form, and how what is the power loss and how do you calculate the efficiency. So these all parameters we have already seen in the previous video. So in this video we take one example, we consider one example, and I will show you various techniques to convert the power from one form to another form. So we will understand this in today's lecture. So let us say this is your basic block diagram. Okay, so you have one DC-DC converter here, and let us say you have some input voltage, a source voltage Vs which is equals to 24 volt. Then we have a load voltage which is equal to 12 volt, that is equal to V out, and so V out equals to 12 volt, and your load resistance is 12 ohm and your load current is 1 ampere. This is our requirement. Okay, so what we have got is, and we have output voltage of 12 volt and output current, load current is 1 ampere and load resistance is 12 ohm, right? This is the requirement we have already with us. Now the question is, how can this converter be realized? There will be several methods to realize this converter, to convert 24 volt to 12 volt. Okay, so we will take some 2-3 techniques, and I will show you how this 24 volt can be converted into a 12 volt 1 ampere. So our first technique is dissipative realization. Okay, this is the dissipative realization. In this realization, this is the first method I'm gonna tell you. So this is a resistive voltage realization. So you have your source voltage, supply voltage which is equal to 24 volt, you have your load voltage, load current which is equal to 12 volt and 1 ampere. So input, your output power is 12 volt into 1 ampere, that is equal to 12 watt. Since this is resistive voltage divider method, so the same current flow will flow through the source what you are delivering at your load. So your input power is 24 watt. Okay, 24 multiply by 1 ampere, you will get 24 watt. So now you have input power 24 watt and you have your output power 12 watt. So if you want to calculate the power loss, P loss equals to your input power minus your output power, that means 24 watt minus 12 watt, you will have P loss equals to 12 watt. Okay, so in resistive voltage divider method, you will have a additional resistance. This is the additional resistance which is connected in this block. You have an additional resistance which will dissipate a 12 watt power. Okay, which will dissipate a 12 watt power here. So you can see, if you use your resistive voltage divider method to generate a 24 volt to 12 volt 1 ampere, you have a power loss of 12 volt. Okay, this is the 12 volt, so power loss is 12 volt. So you can see by this realization technique you have energy loss which is 12 watt. So you may not use this technique frequently to generate 24 volt to 12 volt, right? So let us understand the second technique, which is also comes under dissipative realization. So in the second realization method, we have series pass regulator. Okay, so in the block, under the block, we have a transistor. Okay, This is NPN transistor, and we have supply voltage here 24 volt, and we have a load voltage 12 volt and load current 1 ampere. So you can see your input power is 24 watt and your output power is 12 watt. So you have to again dissipate 24 watt minus 12, which is equal to 12 watt power in your transistor. So your transistor will dissipate now 12 watt power. So power loss would be 12 watt. So by using series pass transistor, you are dissipating a 12 watt power across your this transistor. So since the power dissipation is higher here, so you may achieve very less efficiency. This transistor works in a active region. This transistor operates in active region and it dissipates a 12 watt power across it, right? So the second realization method is switching realization. In the switching realization, we have realization method that is third, switching converter. So in this method, we have within the block, we have a MOSFET, we have a diode, we have inductor, and we have a capacitor. And outside a block, you have your supply voltage, which is equals to 24 volt, and you have your load connected here, which is equal to 12 volt, 1 ampere. So your output power would be 12 watt. But in this case, since you are driving your switching converter by using PWM technique, so here you will have a very less power loss and you can achieve a very high efficiency. So in this case, you have a very less power loss and you can achieve a very high efficiency. How this power loss is very small? P loss equals to very small. How? So this will, I will cover this topic in forthcoming lecture. So as of now, you can see you have a requirement to convert 24 volt to 12 volt 1 ampere, and you have seen three methods: by using resistive divider methods, by using transistor series pass transistor method, and by using switching converter. And you have seen that by using switching converter, you have very less power loss. So thanks for watching this video. If you have any question, feel free to ask me in comment section.